A very good morning to all our viewers who've just joined us this morning on Breakfast Show. A very good morning to you, and we hope all is well as you start to begin your new week and new Monday this week. Organizing smooth, running, worry-free, inspirational and memorable vacations, holidays and itineraries all over the world is not an easy task. A small business in Fiji, but of global travel and tour standards, Dynasty Tour and Travels, an accredited agency in Mumbai in India and now in Suva. The travel business was established in 2017 by a family from India who decided to embark on this journey and give opportunities to locals to travel overseas. Our Breakfast Show reporter, Nani Sesivo, with his story.
I love the whole pace of Fiji. I know a lot of people find it very laid back, but considering where we're coming from a very busy city in India, Bombay. So we were very happy with the pace over here. It's not too fast, it's not too slow. I love the fact that there's not so, I know people say there is a lot of traffic here, but if you come to Bombay and see the traffic, you will really not find this traffic at all. So I love the fact that there's no pollution. There are a lot of pluses which you know, we've seen, because we can compare it with a city where everything is like a rat race.
This is one of the many heartwarming responses you will hear from tourists and from someone who has decided to move to the Pacific region to start a business. Awarded by the Tourism Fiji as a Matai specialist, her company has been at the forefront of the niche travel industry by researching and determining the very best suppliers and destination management partners worldwide.
So my name is Hriday, and we run a travel agency called Dynasty Tours and Travels. We've been running it since 2017. That's when we came into Fiji. And we absolutely fell in love with Fiji and decided never to go back.
Hriday Daswani, also known as Tina to her family and friends, is a mother, a wife and a licensed immigration advisor, whereby she runs a travel company that handles inbound and outbound operations. She has an office in Mumbai, India, as well as here in Suva.
Now when I think back, I'm like, thank God I studied it. At least we have something else to do now, right? So after studying it, we applied for the license, and just recently we got the license from New Zealand as a licensed immigration advisor. So I'm officially allowed to now give immigration advice, you know, to anyone who is looking to travel or to study or work in New Zealand, or even eventually migrate to New Zealand and Australia.
She said being awarded the Matai Specialist Award was something she aimed for, to promote Fiji, a tourism gateway to the world.
Love for this country, we decided to even try and promote Fiji as a great, we are anyway doing it with the travel to promote Fiji as a tourist destination. Along with that, we decided to start trying to bring in students so that, you know, for the universities here, because that will kind of bring in revenue to Fiji. We've even started looking at options of bringing in people who want to invest in Fiji for businesses, because that's technically how we came. So getting people in to set up businesses over here and invest in Fiji. So these are the kind of thoughts that have started coming, or the kind of things that we're started doing now, you know, in order to have something else to do besides the travel and tourism.
From her hometown in Mumbai to a small country like Fiji, Hriday shared the working environment is not different at all. They have received massive responses from Fijians ever since they started in 2017.
As hard as one would think, maybe also because we are from, or we have an office in India as well. India has so much of paperwork and, you know, so when we came here, we were not very stuck, or we didn't really, I know a lot of people find it hard to set up businesses, but I think we were, for us it was very easy actually, and everyone's so helpful, and we didn't have any problems at all.
Dynasty Travels and Tours for the past 3 years has offered one of the best travel packages for locals and tourists.
Dynasty is actually a company which has been around since the year 2000, so it's a 20-year-old company. So our office in India, which is also a travel and tour company, is also goes by the name of Dynasty Tours and Travels. So we just decided to stick with the same name and start up a company here. So now even our immigration and visa services comes under Dynasty. So we still keep the same name. Maybe it's just proved to be lucky for us.
Deswani said every businesses have challenges, but with tours and travel businesses, convincing your customers to trust your service is a challenge.
Initially, it's just to establish yourself, get people to trust your services, you know, get the some kind of like the different to go around and try and convince corporates or in you know, kind of let them know why you should be servicing them rather than somebody else. And because we have you know, those many years of experience behind us, we get a lot of, we've got different airline systems that we use, so we our prices are more competitive because we have a larger inventory of airlines that we can utilize or that we work with. Also probably because of the fact that we do tours, you know, or we're probably only one of the only ones in Suva who are doing packaged tours. So a lot of clients over here or a lot of people over here prefer that idea of having a package sold to them. So where, you know, you get picked up from the airport, your hotel is already taken care of, you know, your sightseeing is already in it, and then you're dropped back to the airport after your whole trip.
With the borders still closed, the pandemic has really affected her business.
The COVID coming in this year, it's been quite a turmoil because all the travel businesses, like, you know, have suffered quite a bit. Not only the travel agencies, but even the whole tourism sector as a whole. And so with that, we decided to start brainstorming and come up with some different ideas of what we can do during this period. And that's when we decided to move towards doing different kinds of immigration services and visas, like students and work visas, seasonal workers. So that's when this whole line came into play. We started in 17, we slowly grew. The following year, 18, we grew still further. 19 went still even better. And the first quarter of 20 was going great as well. So right up till March, we were pretty much good. And I think towards the last week of March is where, you know, things started going down, and then the borders started shutting. And so from April onwards, we've had absolutely zero business. And it has been very hard, you know, after that. So for the last 3 months, we're just trying to kind of sustain and waiting and hoping for things to go back to normal.
She wishes to encourage those who want to start a business to dream big and use the talent that you have within you.
Follow your dream for sure, because it's, you know, if you're passionate about something, you will, there's no stopping you really. Like when we started in 17, we were like literally starting from scratch all over again, and we were just so excited about the whole thing that we were not even worried, you know, we were just so sure that it would happen. So yeah, I guess as long as you're confident and positive about it, it's perfectly fine to go ahead and dream.
Ride Deswani and her family are hoping for the borders to open soon so that business can normalize again. However, they look forward to continue to serving Fijians in the days to come. This is Nani Sesivo for The Breakfast Show.